Hi everyone, welcome to Living Overseas on a Dime. I'm Noel.
I'm Jenny.
And today we're going to talk about the packing that we have done now after traveling for 6 months as a nomadic family.
I can't believe it's been 6 months already. Yeah.
And for sure, you know what, one thing that has happened is we have really trimmed down what we have.
Absolutely. Yeah. We've gotten rid of 2 suitcases. We used to travel with 3 suitcases. Yeah. Now we're traveling with 1 suitcase.
Yeah.
And 2 of our 40-liter backpacks.
Yeah. And a couple little personals.
Yeah.
We'll show you as we go today as to what we put in each bag. But you know what? Today, join us and you'll get to see. We're not minimalists, we don't think, but we try our best to cut down what we can for traveling.
Yeah.
So here we go. So today we're going to be talking about what we have in our bags, how we pack our bags, and what we've got now traveling as a nomadic family. And the way that we kind of organize our bags is really based upon thinking about activities. And we do it in one really simple way, which is what are we going to wear inside and what are we going to wear outside?
Mm-hmm.
And that kind of helps to get you organized and thinking, okay, what do I actually need? Rather than, oh, I might need this, I might need that, I might need this, I might need that. Because the might need thinking is dangerous. Oh. And then you end up with, you know, 4 bags each. Sort of thing.
And that's how we started off with. You know, it's really hard for people who are taking a whole house, is what we did, and try and get rid of everything and fit everything into a suitcase. We have a little storage unit back home with some very sentimental personal items, but not much. We literally got rid of all of our clothing, and we pretty much have everything with us.
Yeah.
So it's really overwhelming going from a huge house to fitting everything in a suitcase and 2 bags. And over the 6 months, we've gotten rid of lots of clothing. We took way too much clothing. Remember, you can buy stuff while you're
absolutely
traveling.
Absolutely.
Right? Like, that was our big mistake. It's like, oh, let's bring this, let's bring that.
Yeah.
Oh, that's my favorite pair of pants. Blah, 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 blah. You can buy stuff. And chances are you'll find something nice while you're traveling that you do want to buy.
Yeah, right? There are a few things that we'll talk about later that you might not be able to get. So there are some little things, little pointers of stuff that you do want to pick up before you go, or be aware and kind of on the lookout for them.
Yes.
But now we're going to start on my stuff, okay? Which is, we'll give you a shot here and maybe a link to a video on one of these sides as to, this is my Osprey bag.
Yeah.
Okay. So for my clothing in my bag, the Osprey, I start off with 3 pairs of pants. Now, that being said, this is still too much.
It is. The one pair of pants you've never worn.
Exactly. The 1 pair of pants are a nice pair just in case, I don't know, I'm going on a fancy date or something.
Yeah.
They're kind of like, I don't even know what
they are.
They're still
nice,
very light.
Like, really nice, sweat wicking. They don't wrinkle.
Yeah.
They're super nice.
They're kind of like a dress pant. But
so we brought 1 pair of dress pants for a fancy dinner that we've never worn yet.
Yeah. The other pair here, and this is the outdoor pair. This is actually a dual purpose. It's got zippers so you can take them off. And
they're just a basic Columbia pair. And he has worn those.
Yeah, those I wore, you can see on the Istanbul video.
Yeah.
And once again, going to the indoor outdoor, the other pair is kind of like a pajama type bottom that I can wear if it's cooler in the house.
Again, we haven't worn that very much because it's been so hot, right?
Yeah.
So 3 pairs of pants.
Okay, next, and this is, I personally kind of organize my stuff into activities. So I have like a set of running clothes almost, and that comes back from Canada when I was running and the few times I've managed to actually get out running while we've been traveling. And that's my windbreaker, which I'm not sure where that's at.
Right,
it's
here.
Okay, yeah.
Just a thin windbreaker.
It's just a thin windbreaker.
Yeah.
Also useful if it's a little cooler out with wind. And it's super light, so
super
that's
light,
really nice.
And we can wash it in the sink, no problem.
Now, next one is my rain jacket. Now, this, somehow, we've only had 1 day of rain, so I haven't managed to actually wear it. We're going to Thailand soon, so that probably will be worn after Turkey and Bulgaria. But, that was, I guess, a reveal there. Well, anyway, so I don't know. But this is one of the things that you should get in your home country.
Yes.
Okay? This is a Columbia. Mine's a Columbia. Jenny's, I can't remember what yours is. Is yours a
Columbia?
I'll
have to look at my brand.
But finding high quality rain gear that you know is good is something you want to do before you leave, because you want nice, breathable, easy to wear, good for hiking, good for cities that are hot. You have to keep that in mind if you're going to be going to tropical countries. Yeah. So that's something you definitely want to buy when you're back in your home
country.
Primarily because
we have seen some sports stores while we're traveling, and they're extremely expensive.
Like 3 to 5 times the cost of North America.
So if you can get something on sale for cheaper, we highly recommend buying it before you go.
Yeah. Then we get into just basic shirts. And now with the shirts, it's kind of interesting because this also is indoor-outdoor. Mm-hmm. This is more of a poly blend. They always have a little bit of almost like, it's not a plastic, but it's really good for sweat wicking. Yeah. So it's something if you're going to hotter climates that I personally prefer. Some people don't like them, but you really need to look and find ones that you like.
Yeah. Another good compromise is merino wool. I know lots of people like that as well. But, if you don't have the budget, when we were planning our wardrobe, we just didn't have the money for merino wool. So, this is from Superstore.
In Canada. It's like Walmart, basically.
It's like Walmart, and Walmart has it. So you go to any of the sports sections in any of the big stores. If you look at the sports section, as long as it's like got a polyester blend, it'll be fine. Some aren't as soft as others, so try them on. But these ones you really liked. And again, I've washed a lot in the sink, especially in Mexico, and they dry within an hour or 2 hours. Super easy to wash, especially for hand washing. So how many of those do you have? You've got a lot.
Quite a few of my shirts are those. Once again, it's an indoor-outdoor.
Yes.
So I still have thinner cotton that I like to wear at home, especially in the mornings or in the evenings, if it's a touch cooler. But outdoor, I almost exclusively wear the blends.
Yeah, for sure.
Indoor and for sleeping, I have a sleeping shirt that's a longer sleeve that's a cotton.
Yeah.
So, it kind of depends on what you like.
Yeah. In total, you have 10 shirts.
Yeah. I'd say probably 6 of them are the blends, or 6 or 7.
And then 3 cotton shirts, I think. So.
Next is my shorts. I have 5 pairs of shorts. Now, this is a little bit misleading because actually, I think 2 or 3 of them are actually running shorts.
Yes.
So that's more for my running activities. Those things get gross because I sweat like crazy when I run. But funny enough, the another 2 pair of shorts I have are identical. They're like, they have liners. They're like a blue. Does that one look here? Yeah, they're Columbia. They're a Columbia short.
They're great.
They have a nice little thing for a belt.
Belt.
And they have a liner that, you know what, is great if you're out on a super hot day and you
absolutely
don't want your cotton underwear to get nasty.
Those we got off Amazon, I think they're only $25, and you love them.
Absolutely,
great. That's your go-to short when it's hot out.
Yeah, and you know what? It's nice. I have 2 pairs, so if one gets gross, you just wash. Mm-hmm. You can wear the other one and rotate. That's kind of the way we do it.
And one nice thing with those shorts, if you need a backup pair of bathing suit as well, you can, because it's got the inner lining. You never did. You have one bathing suit, but you can wear that as well, right? So
next are my 3 long sleeve shirts. One of those is a running shirt. Again, they kind of dual purpose. And then we also have sleeping shirts. So really my long sleeve shirts are only sleeping shirts. That one that I can rotate when it's gross. That's about it, really. After that is my underwear. 5 pairs of underwear. Primarily, we just wash them as we go. And you know what? We do a fair amount of sink washing if need be. Mm-hmm. Some of the places we've had have had really good washing machines. And in Turkey so far, it's been super easy to dry stuff because it's been pretty dry.
Yeah.
So if it's humid, it's a bit more of an issue. There's always a little trick with thinner stuff is you can use the hair dryer if you got to.
That's true.
You can. Just be careful with making it too hot, but you can.
Yeah.
It's a little travel trick if you really got to. Socks. I have 7 pairs of socks, and that's also because I run. So it's something that, if you mostly wear sandals, you might not even need that. You may need a couple pairs. But for me, I need a few extra pairs. Also, I have weird foot temperature issues, so I often need socks. Well, this is interesting. So just right before we started shooting here, I said, oh, hey, I thought I had 2 bathing suits. And Jenny just said, no, you only need 1 anyway. So we got rid of 1. I guess I started with 2 and now I just have 1.
Well, primarily 2. And we're finding, now that we're out of Mexico, we're not really hitting any beach destinations.
Yeah.
And even when we were doing beach destinations, we only really need one bathing suit.
Yeah, unless you're a surfer and it's getting really salty or a diver or something.
Yeah, we usually go once a day. We come home, we rinse it and wash it. It dries that night, and then we use it the next day. We don't really need two bathing suits.
Yeah, and if you did, you could pick up another one. That's the reality. Exactly. So it's just not worth making your bag that much heavier.
No.
Last but not least is the two sweaters. This one is definitely cut down. I don't know if it was coming from Winnipeg, which is like frigidly cold a lot of the year. But even our sweaters, I think I really just have the one hoodie. And it's not even a sweater. It's a plaid, like a long sleeve shirt. So you know what? Like where we've traveled, I think I've worn the hoodie twice when it was cooler in Istanbul and we came from Mexico, and the long sleeve shirt maybe once. So that, you know what, these sort of things you also can look at, okay, where am I traveling? And if you're going somewhere that's primarily hot, you won't need those things. If you do, you can probably buy something.
Yeah, absolutely.
So this, oh, I have a couple other things that are outdoor here. So something interesting is that in most of the countries we have gone to, they will have indoor and outdoor shoes. So unless you want to use their shoes, especially in Muslim countries and Asian countries, bring your own indoor flip-flops. They should be comfy and padded. I like my Tevas. I also have a pair of outdoor flip-flops if I just don't want to get, you know, put on my shoes and I'm just going to the little corner store or something. So it's, or for the beach. So I personally have two pairs of flip-flops. They're light. They're easy to pack. They go right into my Osprey. No issue on the sides or the outdoor pockets. So this is something. So I have two pairs of flip-flops. One other, I have one pair of running shoes, which in the beginning I had two. I would have a dedicated running pair and a walking pair. Now I'm just, the theory, it hasn't really worked, and I'll tell you in a second why, is that I wear one pair and just get a new pair sooner as the miles get on them. Now, that hasn't worked. Funny enough, in Turkey, we found that men have small feet, and like I'm only a 10 and a half in US sizes, and I can't find shoes that fit me. It's almost unbelievable.
It's crazy.
Like, especially I like Asics. They're my shoe that I love running in.
Yeah.
And these are 10 and a halves, and I have not been able to find a pair of 10 and a halves in the specific shoe that I like.
Yeah.
So this is just something to be aware of. This is goes back to the jackets. If you have a specific brand that you're interested in, it might be worth bringing an extra pair or really paying attention when you're going to a new place. We're going to a couple new countries in the near future. And actually, shoes are very high on our priority list of things to buy just because I can't get them here. And I'm not willing to get a brand I don't really like.
Yeah. And, you know, we just assumed like 10 and a half. Yeah, it's not a huge foot. Now, some other brands in Turkey, they did have, like, they had some Nikes.
Yeah.
But the Nikes you tried on, you didn't really
like. I didn't like them, yeah.
So it might just be an ASICS thing, but it seemed like lots of brands, 10 and a half was considered a big size.
Yeah.
So it might just be Turkey. We're hoping in Bulgaria we can find some.
Yeah, or Thailand if we got to wait.
Or Thailand, hopefully we can find some like that will fit you and the brand you like. Primarily, you know, we just didn't want to lug a lot of shoes around, and we just assumed, oh, we could find that brand, but we're finding it more difficult than we thought, right?
Yeah, just something to be aware of when you're considering what you should pack.
For Noel's bag, he has the Osprey 40 liter, so it's a totally different setup than my Eagle Creek. He has a front zip-up pocket, and then the main compartment, which is just one big compartment like that. And then he has two zipper pockets here. On these two zipper pockets inside, I put his underwear on one side and his socks on the other. And then I just lay all of his clothes flat inside the big compartment. So I'll show you that right now. then his flip-flops I put just in this front pocket. That. One, two. And then his rain jacket he likes to keep in the second pocket there. And that's it. That is packed. This is probably the most important piece of gear that we have in our whole backpack. And this is a luggage weigher. So we got this off Amazon. It was cheap. I can't remember how much it was. So it weighs in kilograms and in pounds. And all you do is press your little button. It's got a little clippy thing. So you just hook it on like that. And it's on kilograms right now. And then you just go like this. And then you just pick it up. Okay, that's Noel's backpack, 8.15. That's all of his clothing. So his clothing is always more heavy than mine because his pieces are bigger. So I bet you I'll have tons of space in my backpack still, and then we'll just transfer some over. So let's see how much mine is. This is with all, oh, sorry. Here we go. So reset it. Oh yeah, not even six. So we just weigh it out, and then I'll just take some of Noel's stuff and put it in mine because I have tons of extra space still. So most airlines were allowed 8 kilograms for carry-on. We've never had any problems bringing both backpacks on. They don't blink an eye. They've never really even weighed it, never mind. So, and if they do weigh it, we have more than enough weight left over. So we highly recommend get a baggage weigher.
So I hope this video today was of help to you in just seeing how I pack my bag and specifically the bag for taking as carry-on.
And I'm going to be doing a video on my bag and what I pack later on. So you'll be able to see that maybe next week.
Yeah, and we'll have a couple other little packing tips too. So you know what? Hope it was of help. Stay safe and happy travels.
Happy travels.